segment of the show for this morning. And of course, we've been joined by Miss Kathy Buckner. Miss Buckner is a former member of the Matthew 25 homeless organization, and she is also a member of the homeless project that Mr. Daniels and Miss Greenlee are a part of. And of course, Miss Buckner, let me welcome you to the show this morning.
Thank you.
And let me tell you, Miss Buckner, how delighted we are to have you here, because we know that you've been involved with the homeless population for quite a while, and that one of those organizations that you've been involved in is a very, very successful organization in Nashville, yes. And that was Matthew 25. Let's talk about that, and then leading up to your new activity involved in the homeless project that we talked about earlier.
Okay, and it's the Nashville Homeless Power Project is
Nashville
the name of
homeless.
That organization.
Very good.
Yes, I worked at Matthew 25 for 12 years mm-hmm. as a program director, mm-hmm. and it was a successful program that actually helped. I worked with homeless vets to get them off the street. Mm-hmm. There are at least 500 homeless veterans on the street in any one night here in Nashville. Mm-hmm. There's already homeless individuals coming back from this war mm-hmm. homeless. Mm-hmm. Before I left there and started working with the National Homeless Power Project, mm-hmm. there were already two that came in December. Mm-hmm. And so I know there are mm-hmm. going to be more from this war mm-hmm. homeless than are now homeless from the Vietnam
earlier war.
Uh-huh. Right, because earlier. Most mm-hmm. veterans are Vietnam veterans. Mm-hmm. I was solicited by the Nashville Homeless Power Project to actually come and work with them mm-hmm. Because of my work with the Homeless Commission. Mm-hmm. And it is extremely important that mm-hmm. Nashville is true to their promise. Mm-hmm. As the Homeless Commission, we were one of the 10 key cities mm-hmm. That the mayor's office mm-hmm. set us up, because he was over that program mm-hmm. to be one of the key cities that actually had a program to end chronic homelessness mm-hmm. In the next 10 years. Mm-hmm. And we are sorely behind mm-hmm. In our promise mm-hmm. to do that. Mm-hmm. And that's one of the things I'm working on with the Nashville Homeless Power Project, is to do what we call the Housing Options Program, mm-hmm. which will also work towards getting some housing mm-hmm. that will be run by formerly homeless people mm-hmm. to serve homeless and formerly homeless people, because we know best what the problems are mm-hmm. and know how to deal with the population and want to mm-hmm. Be able to do that. But the city also needs to make good on their promise mm-hmm. because there is a need for a service center downtown yeah. or somewhere mm-hmm. else where people can get in out of the elements, yeah, that mm-hmm. they can use a restroom, mm-hmm. that they can get something to eat without mm-hmm. having to do panhandling. Mm-hmm. And it is our responsibility mm-hmm. as a community to mm-hmm. not have people sleeping mm-hmm. In places where,
under the bridges,
right,
and
where humans are not supposed to be mm-hmm. sleeping.
You know, as a matter of fact, you know, it simply occurs to me that you've had an opportunity to be involved in this for a long time, and do you see any real progress that we've made in Nashville over the last many years dealing with this as an issue? That is, more housing, more shelter for the disadvantaged individuals, those individuals who might fall into the homeless category?
Unfortunately, mm-hmm. we have with our Hope 6 programs mm-hmm. or whatever, torn down public housing mm-hmm. and put back housing that is better mm-hmm. because we do recognize that public housing clusters mm-hmm. do not work. Mm-hmm. But the people who are moving into those units mm-hmm. are not the people who moved out of them.
Okay. Uh-huh.
And so there's not enough housing that is based on mm-hmm. somebody's income. Mm-hmm. That is for people who are waiting on disability that mm-hmm. don't have an income. Mm-hmm. I mean, this city, this state actually takes.
This country.
We are the mm-hmm. slowest mm-hmm. as a, we're number 50th mm-hmm. on the fact that it takes at least 18 months for when somebody has a heart attack or a stroke or something that physically happens to them before they could get disability. And why does somebody have to become homeless, lose everything they had, worked for, had, in order to be able to get what they worked for? And that's how it happens a lot of the time in this country. This also is about a third of the homeless in Nashville have mental health issues.